Boxing has changed my life. My name is Tori Nelson, ranked number one in the United States, ranked number two in the world.
Tori's strengths as a boxer are actually multifaceted. You can't teach instincts to fight.
A lunch lady, a bus driver, and IHOP waitress, and a pro boxer.
And she always has a smile on her face and enthusiastic and energized.
All those things, she's a role model for so many.
I'm going to go to be the world champion. That's what I'm here for. My boxing name is Sho-Nuff, is my ring name. I'm the only girl of three boys, and I had to really defend myself. I had to play football with them if I wanted anybody to play with. So I'm rough anyway.
I never knew that she fought all through school. When I told one of the principals of her school, her high school, so I told her about Tori boxing. She says she wasn't surprised at all. She says, well, finally, she's putting it to good use.
I know she can handle herself. Growing up, she was a tomboy. And like I said, she got me and then an older brother. And I know I was forever beating up on her. And then playing basketball in high school, ran track. We played yard football. And the neighborhood guys, we were not easy. We would literally tackle her. So she grew up pretty tough.
Although I wanted a little princess, a little fashion model, or a little flight attendant, I remember once a friend of mine came over and they were saying, Jackie, I thought you had a daughter. And I said, I do. I said, she's outside playing with the kids. And she says, which one? I said, the one with the football uniform on.
I went to the gym actually just to work out, and Craig asked me, what would I want out of it if I was to compete? I said, I'm gonna be the world champion.
My first impression of Tori was like no other, like any other fighter actually. She came in. She wanted to get in shape. I figured she'd be in there a month training, then be gone, to be honest with you. So it wasn't like, you know, I saw her and thought, oh, this is the one. This is the girl that's going to be a world champion.
The first time I met Craig and the first time I walked into Craig's gym, and he just blew me off. He's just like, what do you want? What do you want to come here for? I was like, I'm coming because I'm going to work out and I'm going to be a boxer. And he just gave me this look like, yeah, okay. I said, I'm looking to be the world champion. And the look he gave me was like, you and who else? Who going to help you get there?
I think it's really exciting. It's like a thrill ride, kind of. We have our ups and downs. It's like big adventure, really.
Actually, Tori was boxing a couple of years before she even let me know that's what she was doing.
Yes, it was my second deployment when I was in Iraq. I called my mom's. It was like late in deployment, so it was like, I asked her, have she talked to Tori lately? She said, yeah, she's boxing. I'm like, she's what? She's boxing. And shortly after that, that's when I found out she had won Golden Glove. I'm like, what? And that was impressive to me, truly impressive, because going from just straight hearing it, like she's boxing now, and then winning Golden Gloves, I was like, I didn't know what to say.
Actually, what inspired me into boxing was once I got older. I used to fight all the time in school. So once I got older, I just, being in the boxing gym, once I saw how they were doing, and it's really a great stress reliever. I stay happy because I release my stress in the ring. But I love boxing. I do. I love it. I used to watch Muhammad Ali was always with Tyson. Muhammad Ali was old by the time I came along, but I used to watch Tyson. I loved Tyson. I loved him. But my favorite boxers are Joe Frazier, my old school boxers, Joe Frazier and Tyson, and now my up-to-date boxers is Manny Pacquiao. Boxing has changed my life. Boxing has kept me healthy, kept my, because at first I was a little overweight, because I like to eat. But boxing keep me working out all the time. It may not be too good for my children because all we do, I say I got the three B's in my life, Bible, babies, and boxing. We go to church. We go to the gym. And I take care of my kids. That's my life.
Tori's strengths as a boxer are actually multifaceted. You can't teach instincts to fight. She instinctively comes forward and is willing to fight. And that's hard. You can't teach that to a boxer. So she's got heart and she's determined. So that would be her strength as a boxer.
Craig came to me about 2 years ago. He had lost his gym. He needed a new place to train. He didn't have the money to go out here and start a new gym. So we kind of got our heads together and I said, listen, I got this garage. I can clean everything out of it. And, hey, you can use it. It's not going to cost you anything. There's no heat and no AC in there, but if you can do it. And he's like, Chris, we'll do anything.
And I started working out in the garage. I had my corner man's Chris garage. And it was so cold. I'm so thankful for this. It was, when it's cold outside, rain, sleet, or snow, we was in there.
Coming in there in 90 plus heat in the morning and training, and then sub-zero weather in the winter, I can remember 2 foot of snow being on the ground and carving a path up the driveway to get them in here. And they're in here, you know, they'd wake me up every morning, they were my alarm clock. For about a year and a half, I'd wake up to the mitts cracking.
I remember some days working out in sweatshirts and breathing, and you could see the coldness from my breath. And then in the summertime, it'd be so hot that we have to have the garage doors up just so we could get some air. But yes, that's my working out.
5 days a week, she trains for an hour and a half. When she actually has a fight, it's a 5 week training camp. And she does two-a-days. So in the morning, she trains for an hour. She does conditioning and running. And in the evening, we do fundamental training and sparring. But we train consistently. Even when she does not have a fight, she's always training. We don't get in shape for a fight. She's always in shape to fight.
My sparring is very important. That's your fight before your fight. Your fight that you have, your actual bout, is the reward. But sparring, I have great sparring partners. I have Kyra Vargas, that's just wonderful. And I have Franchon Cruz, she's the Panamanian champion. And I have Dara Shin. We always the ones that travel, and we go out to Maryland or DC twice a week. We go to Alexandria to spar with Dara or Franchon or both. And we go out to Maryland or DC sometimes and go out and spar with whatever girl I can find. But now I spar here also with my boys.
She got like four jobs, a lunch lady, a bus driver, and IHOP waitress. And the fourth one is the boxer, a pro boxer.
My weekly schedule, Monday mornings, I wake up at 6 o'clock in the morning as I drive school bus for Loudoun County. I'll be on my bus by 7. I have to wake my daughter up.
Monday, I'm with her in the mornings because I get on the bus with her and she takes me to school and we have like mother-daughter conversations. It's like I'm really cool with her. She's like my best friend.
I love my job. I love it because it's something different every day. Every day, you never know what to expect from those kids. Kids say whatever they want, and I love it. In the middle of the day, I work out. I work in the school also. I help with the kids in the cafeteria, or I help wherever I need to be. And then I get back on the bus in the evenings. I go to church on Wednesday for a discipleship class. And which I'm passing with all A's, is to get closer to the Lord, to learn more from the bottom to the top of what God and what Jesus has done for us. And by that time when I finished, my mom asked me, are you going to be a boxing pastor? No, no, I'm not going to be a boxing pastor. But I do want to just be, I want to get more involved in the church and do more with the church. So I have to know what God has done for me and what God has done for all of us in order for me to get to that point.
As a person, Tori's strengths are she's a very giving person. So everybody likes Tori, actually loves Tori because of the type of person she is. She'll give you the shirt off her back. She does for others before she does for herself.
On Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, I work at IHOP at night to 2 in the morning, and that's my adult time. I see and talk to all different kind of people, and you never know what they're going through that day, or if you can help them, or if they can help me.
I'm hoping to get a job there when I turn 15, so I can be with her and me working together.
But I like it because I interact. I love talking to people. I just love talking. So I love my jobs. I go home and get, 5 hours of sleep, and I start all over again.
She's a hardworking single mother.
And then Sunday is my off day. That's what I call my off day.
And then on Sundays is like our relaxed day, the break, we have to chill.
I grew up in the church. When I was little, my mom always had us in the church, always. Every Sunday we was in the church. And my grandma used to tell us all the time, you can party all night on Saturday, but Sunday morning you going to church. So I got away from it a little bit when I grew up. But then you always find home. You always find a way back. I have my children in it faithfully because I want them to be raised that way, to raise their children. So I love God, I do. After I come out of church on Sunday, sometimes I take a nap. Most of the days I take my children out and then we go out to eat, we go shoot basketball. I mean, it's their day. On Sundays, it's their day. And by the time I come back home, I pass out. That is a week with Tori. Yes, a lot. Wow. The journey to my first fight. It was nerve-wracking. My very first fight was with a girl named Estelle Brown. And I actually fought her again. I beat her. And then the next time she wanted a rematch, so I had to fight her again. But I had to do my shoulder out. So I only had really one arm. One arm, and I still beat her. It was exciting. Blessed, just blessed.
The most memorable thing about Tori's first fight was that she really was lacking in boxing fundamentals. But she had lost weight. She had earned the right to fight. She'd been sparring for about a year. And so her first fight, she won, but she won it with heart and determination. She was dead tired after two rounds, and going into the third round, she really didn't have anything left. And I looked her in the eye and I said, hey, you gotta want this, And she sucked it up and won that fight. And I knew after that first fight that she had what it took to be a fighter, because she had nothing left and she was able to, muster that last little tank of gas, and she had it and the other girl didn't, and that was the difference in her first fight. So
we trained so hard, and I was way bigger, 180, 170 something pounds at that fight, so I was much heavier, and I knew going those three rounds was gonna be something hard.
I was kind of on the edge of my seats, digging in my nails, just oh my gosh. But she was really relaxed and cool with it.
But I never thought about going those three rounds carrying my weight and hers, because by the end of the fight, she was laying on me. My lungs were burning. My nose was burning. I had never, ever felt that before. The feeling was it was crazy. But the victory, oh wow. I couldn't believe it. I smiled all night. Even the next day, I was still smiling. I was just happy.
Yeah, afterwards is a big reunion and everything. When the referee raises up her hand and says, Tori, Sho-Nuff Nelson.
Thank you, Jesus. Congratulations.
My first fight was my toughest fight. because I didn't know what to expect. Sparring and boxing, the actual match, is totally different. Sparring gets you ready, but once you're in there, it's very different, especially as my first time. My nerves were so bad. Right before the fight, I had to throw up. My nerves, it's terrible. But Craig always said, he just the comforter in it all. He'll say, it's okay, T, because if you wasn't nervous, that means something is wrong. Okay, I don't think I'm supposed to be this nervous. But the first fight was his best, and he loved it. Anytime, if you ask him what was my best fight, he would say my very first fight.
So I would say that the most memorable fight was her second pro fight. She fought a very good fighter, Rachel Clark. And Rachel Clark, we have a lot of respect for. She's very scary to look at. She's an absolute specimen as far as a fighter, and everyone thought that I was making a mistake for her to fight Rachel. But styles make fights, and I knew that Tori could do well against her. And so it was a big victory for us. But just trusting in, you know, what we do in the ring and you know, knowing her, I knew she was up for it, and she was able to win that fight convincingly.
The best one, I was fighting Shelly Siebert. Right off the bat, you know, you're nervous. I fought her once before, we had a tie. It was a draw, but everybody said I beat her. But I mean, it doesn't matter what everybody else say, it's what the refs say and what the officials say. So this fight was, it was different. And then being that we headbutted, and so I only had like one eye to really fight with because this one was closing. And I had never got hurt in a fight.
It's one of her toughest fights because she was matched against a much bigger, physically stronger opponent, but she was able to overcome that. She got a draw. Eventually, she did get the rematch, and she won.
So she was fighting once again a very good fighter in Shelly Siebert, who we have a lot of respect for. Shelly's done a lot in boxing, and she is a prototypical pro. I mean, Shelly handles her business like a pro. So it was an honor to fight Shelly again. Once again, tough fight, close fight, but Tori won the fight. And just showed us that she's there. She's in a position to fight girls at a high level. Also a very memorable and rewarding fight. That was a very rewarding fight for us.
Almost every fight, she gives somebody a bloody nose or a bloody something or breaks something.
I would love to see her fight. Like I said, I've been seeing all her fights on videotape, on video recorded, and I still have not seen one up front and live, because that would be fun. All my friends watching, I get in the mail, and I'm like, tell them I got a videotape in my sister fighting. So they sit down watching. They sit down watching with me. And they were just like cheering like a regular men boxing, and you know, because it's crazy. Actually, the last fight I watched a fight, those guys were just wilding out because it was just so intense, and everybody was watching it, just fighting. And
that's boxing right there. That's a real thing. A lot of anxiety, a lot of excitement, and in the end, when you win, you can't pay for that.
Oh my gosh, my highlights of the career are every victory.
She sent me a picture with her and her trainer, I guess it was, holding a trophy and everything up, and I was like, cool.
Traveling with Craig, I think, would be my highlights. The things that happen when we're traveling, when we're out in different states and stuff, it's great. Being undefeated, being at the fights, not even, just knowing that I'm about to fight, the adrenaline is just so, I'm just so blessed to be number one in the United States. It's just a true blessing. It's amazing. I love it. My low points in the career is not fighting. It's hard for me to say I'm a boxer when I'm not fighting. I feel that if you're gonna be a boxer, you should do your job. That's my job, that's what I wanna do, that's what I am. So it's hard for people to say, oh, you're that boxer. But it's hard for me to take that title because I really don't feel, that's my lowest. I think I just love boxing. When I'm in that ring, that's my highest. When I'm out that ring and not boxing, that's my lowest.
Tori's weaknesses as a boxer actually are that she likes to fight too much. And you know, lots of times I want her to box and use her fundamental skills, and she'll get too into actually just fighting, and she'll get away from what makes her effective, her actual fundamentals. She'll get away from that occasionally and want to just brawl. And so I have to kind of keep her focused on actually boxing.
I've never seen her get hurt. If she takes a couple punches, I just see her coming forward. She gets mad and comes forward, but she's able to control her emotions and maintain her composure.
My kids love me boxing. My kids love the fact that they like coming to the gym. It's different for them. It changed their life because now they really don't have the outside time to play. But they say, well, Mom, it's okay because we know you're bettering yourself for us. The hardest hill to climb, eating what I want and not until Sunday. Craig said I have to eat professional boxer style, not mama style. My kids, it's hard for me to take them out to eat and I can't eat. Giving up ice cream is my hardest. I love junk food. So I can only have that on Sundays. But I'm adjusted to it now.
Her diet consists of, it's actually low carb when she's not fighting, and high protein. But she is entitled to one day to eat whatever she wants on Sundays. But 6 days a week, she's got a Spartan diet, and on Sunday, she can have what she wants. And it works. She's able to maintain her fight weight, which is 150 pounds.
If I get hurt, then it would be a disaster. Yeah. If I get hurt in my next fight, I can still tell my grandchildren I was number one in the United States and number two in the world. So I'm pretty satisfied. I'm thankful. So I do think they worry about me getting hurt because my son, the very first time he ever saw me sparring, I bloodied the girl's nose really bad and it shook him for like months. He just didn't like it at all. But my daughter, she is all for it. She said, get her mom, just beat her up. But she's the rough one. And he's just, he don't want any marks on me anymore.
Sometimes when she first started boxing, I was like, I hope they don't hit her hard. And then I saw that she was doing most of the hitting, so then I was like, oh, this is gonna be fun. Yeah.
To watch her fight, it's just, it energizes me. And I don't, you know, I don't worry about her getting hurt so much, but I just think she's excellent at what she does for what I know, you know. But no, do I worry about it? We pray her through it. That's it.
With her, anything is possible because she put her mind to it. She's gonna try for it. She succeeds, she'll just keep going, and like this boxing thing. I actually found out through my mom, and she was boxing, and mom was telling me about it, and I never thought of her to be a boxer, but to be number one and number two, and it's just amazing.
My mother loves it. She said, did you have to wait till you were old to get into this? But she loves it. She wasn't surprised at all. Because being raised with all boys and being the only girl, she know what I went through. I've been fighting all the time and then fighting in school. Not that I started any, but I finished a lot. But she wasn't surprised. But she loved it. She come to all my fights, all of them.
Mom thing is pretty cool, but you know, she's a mom, so she gonna worry about it getting hurt and whatnot. Yeah. And mom, she have been to some of the fights.
Her mom's is great mom to have. Mom tries to come to every boxing event that she has.
My father has passed. My father actually passed away in a car accident when I was pregnant with Simone. My father would not like it because to him, I was his diamond. I was my father's princess, just everything. So he wouldn't appreciate this at all. So it's good that I have mom to answer to, so it's good. Yes, boxing is an expensive sport because being that I don't have a sponsor, it comes out of our pockets. My trainer is my manager, so he pays for everything. Even when I travel, he pays for it. He pays for our hotels to stay in. So it's kind of hard if I could please get a sponsor. When we get a sponsor, it's gonna make it so much easier for us and much better, much better. In 1 year, so that would be next year, I see myself maybe not the world champion yet, but on my way to it. In 1 year, on my way to it.
I see her winning the number one title in the world. That's where I see her in a year.
Hi, I'm Tori Nelson. I just would like to say thank you to the country of Trinidad for giving me the opportunity to come out and compete for this WBC title belt. I'm coming for this belt. I came to fight. I trained hard to fight. My trainer and I are going to take the belt home, and I'm just thankful for it. And in order for her to win that belt, she's going to have to kill me for it because I'm coming.
She'll have to kill me, but I'm going to kill her. This is the chance of a lifetime to be here to fight for the WBC World Middleweight title. And to be able to represent Trinidad and Tobago all in the same night, it's a dream come true for me, and I'm not going to let anyone down.
In the battle for the WBC Junior Middleweight title, Larissa Rivas was the aggressor against Tori Nelson. But Nelson fought back coming to the end of the round. The contest shifted so often with Rivas on the attack, and Nelson staging a late assault. Nelson's pressure and help paid dividend in the late and final round. The contest went to the judges for the decision. Tori Nelson won on a split decision, winning the contest 94-96, 93-97, 97-93. Reporting for CNC3 Sports, I'm Astrid Wren.
Hi, I'm Tori Nelson, blessed to be the world champion WBC. I just want to say thank you to the country of Trinidad for giving me the opportunity to come out there and to win this belt. I felt at home. I thank you all for taking me in and making me feel as family and not a visitor. To the people of Trinidad, I thank you. I love you. Look forward to seeing you again. May God bless you.
I take every fight important, just the same. You don't look past a person. You take every fight equally. So I look at her because I know she trained just like I did. She came to fight just like I did. So I don't disrespect her in no way. I know she came. I just know I got to step my game up because she's coming. But I want that belt more.
I'm not even quite as nervous as I should be about it because I'm ready for it. When it's time to get in the ring, I handle my business, in other words.
I love it when I connect and I hit somebody. The stress is gone. You win the fight in the gym. I put so much into what I'm doing, and I stay prayed up, and I work hard to what I want to do. So as long as God gonna do his part, as long as I do my part, I'm okay. So I feel great. Preparation is the key.
If I see an opening, I throw it. I don't plan on just sticking to only throwing a left hook or only throwing a overhand right. When they come open, you throw them.
Nothing is too hard. If you want it, you work for it. It's not, you know, somebody told me, if you want a microwave life, you live a microwave life. But if you want something, you have to work hard for it. And Craig put on my sternum where I have a message out of the Bible that says, pain is certain.
You're gonna go through things, you're gonna go through pain, but if you want it bad enough, you'll keep pushing forward.
The winner by unanimous decision, and she now becomes the WIBA middleweight champion of the world, Sho-Nuff. Tori!
In 10 years, I'll be retired, world champion, and have maybe 2 gyms, and maybe have boxes of my own coming. Once I'm finished, I want to open a gym, especially for females, young females, because it's not just the guys that's on the streets and just getting in trouble, it's females also. So if they could put that to use and positive instead of negative, it could be a lot of Ali's and Joe Frazier's out here, but just in female versions. And we don't get the publicity that the guys get. We don't get paid like the guys do, but we're just as good, even better. Some of our shows even better than theirs. So that's what I'm gonna work on.
In 10 years, I hope that Tori is with me, still involved in boxing, maybe a spokesperson for young women that, you know, are coming up and are struggling, and they can use her life as a model that you can achieve things. I mean, all that she's been through, 3 jobs, 2 kids, doing it on her own, a pro fighter, all those things. She's a role model for so many people, and I think she can use her life experience in 10 years to motivate young people that are coming up and that are struggling.
Hopefully, Tori will be doing something that she loves doing, which is probably, I could see her actually coaching or even training here in the gym. She's a great role model to all of these guys here in the gym. I mean, they all look up to her, they respect her. She demands their respect in the gym.
I'm gonna fight, I'm gonna stay hopefully, prayfully undefeated. And I'm just gonna keep training and go. And they just get it, I'm just gonna get that belt. Afterwards, I wanna help, you know, other people get to where I came from, get to build themselves. Because there's a lot of girls that's out there that has the potential, but they don't have someone to help them. They don't have someone to motivate them. And that's what I want to do.
You know, Tori is a role model not only to, I mean, in the gym, men, grown men, watch how she trains and watches her determination and where she's come from. She's a role model for the men in boxing, in our gym. You know, men look at her and say, wow, you know, she's lost all that weight, she's gotten all these skills.
I want to say thank you first to God for blessing me the way he has. From little black Tori with nothing to now boxing professional, 2 beautiful kids. And I just pray that someday that I get a sponsor. I just pray that somebody hear this or see this and want to sponsor me so I can move forward with it and I don't have to work so hard and I can work hard at what I want to do instead of working hard just to make it.
You know, the future's uncertain for all of us. It's an uncertain future. But we just believe if we keep working hard that good things will happen, and you have to believe that. If you think you're doing the right things and you're living the right way and training hard, that good things are going to happen. It's just human nature. So that's what we believe. We believe if we keep working hard, we're going to get rewarded.
Hard, especially doing it by myself, because I feel sometimes I don't get enough time in to raise my own kids. But I just suck it up and I go, because I know I got 2 mouths I got to feed, you know, without my own.
Pop, pop, pop. They say God does extraordinary things through ordinary people, and this is a prime example of that.
I know I can be way better than what I am if I just had the time to train like I need to. But until that time comes, I just have to keep going. Suck it up, keep going. I want to say thank you to my mom for being the support that I needed, and to my family, my husband, and my children, because my children, without them, they support me. They put all their sports aside, they put everything aside to support me. And I'm thankful for it. And I thank my husband because he's still, even though we're not together, he still is there to help me with my children. He still come, if I say I have a fight and I need to really be there, he'll come and help me with the children. But as far as financially, I mean, he don't, but you know, but. Craig, I love and I adore and I thank him. Because without God and without Craig, I wouldn't be here.
Well, I always have to be careful what I tell Tori because we have kind of this love-hate relationship. So our training is so intense at times that when we're not training, we try to keep it light.
I just think it's amazing how she works three jobs, like on and off, doesn't get like 5 minutes rest time. And she always has a smile on her face and enthusiastic and energized and always want to make other people happy.
Tori says, Ma, when the gloves go on, the smile goes away.
I think she's having fun with it, she's enjoying it. I think it's pretty cool. I think it's fun, actually.
And I love Tori. She's like a daughter that I never had.
She has more heart in her little tiny finger than most people have in their whole entire body. So she's just an incredible person.
As a mother, the tears, I just can't hold them back. Whenever, you know, I'm talking about her or whenever I see her boxing, I'm louder than everybody else. But, or if I read an article about her, it just swells my heart.
My sister, she's an amazing young lady. Two children, single, work four jobs, constantly just laughing and being there for other people. And it's just amazing how she do it. It's, I support her all the way.
When we're done with boxing, she'll always be in my life. That's important.
I just think it's really cool.
We're working with the Loudoun Abused Women's Shelter as far as fundraising. It's a cause that she really supports. And there are other causes that we're going to work towards in the future and have Tori just try and raise funds for them.
She's just tough. She's just, the girl is tough as nails. I've never seen anybody with the tenacity that she has. She's got a real knack and a real, you know, spirit for fighting.
She's just amazing. I love her. She's a backbone for me because she just do it all. She's just beautiful. I love her. She's absolutely great.
It's just unbelievable. I just can't explain how great I feel about her successes.
I plan to go with my career. I'm going to go to be the world champion. That's what I'm here for. That's why God made me. I'm going to be the world champion. And after that, I hold a belt for a while until he blesses somebody else to come and get it. But until then, I'm going to be the world champion.